Good morning, viewers. Once again, I'm the Reverend Dr. Medard Virunjibya Yesu. Today, I am continuing the series about the book of Jonah. And yesterday, we talked about God sending this man to Nineveh and rejecting the call and going into a different direction. But this morning, I wanted to say something about the city of Nineveh. The city of Nineveh was a very big city, very strong, very fortified, very rich, very prosperous. It was a very great city. And this city was very evil. The Bible says in chapter 1, verse 1, the Lord gave this message to Jonah of Amittai, son of Amittai. Get up and go to the great city of Nineveh. Announce my judgment against it, because I have seen how wicked its people are. So the sins of Nineveh were so great. First of all, the city of Nineveh was full of arrogant people. People were very arrogant. They didn't respect God. They didn't respect people. Arrogance and pride was a very huge problem of Nineveh. They were arrogant because their city was beautiful, started by Amroid. They were arrogant because they were rich and prosperous. And they thought that those riches and prosperity were got from themselves. So they disrespected God as a city-state and a very commercial center. Business was at its peak, and so wealth and power, it was strong militarily, so politics, it was strong economically, it was strong also religiously. They had so many gods, and so that city's sins of sexual immorality, full of the city, pride and arrogance, full of the city, the sin of rejecting God and idolatry and witchcraft and occultism, full of the city, bloodshed from one corner to another, and it was also attacking other nations. The city of Nineveh was like the city of Kampala. Kampala has sinned against the Lord. Yesterday, I was reading about the flying scrolls in the book of Malachi. The scroll of corruption, stealing, flying from one city to another. Corruption is a very big problem. It was in Nineveh, it is in Kampala. The sin of sexual immorality, it was in Nineveh, it is in Kampala. The sin of bloodshed, it was in Nineveh, it is in Kampala. The sin of polygamy, the sin of alcohol, and all the orgies as they are described in the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 19. So, as wicked as was the city of Nineveh, so wicked are our cities of Kampala, Mbarara, Mbale, Fort Potro, Guru, Arua. All these cities, they are. The sins of the cities have come up to God. I would like to challenge you that we are living in cities where the judgment of God is coming. We have committed so many sins that our sins are piled up, like Nineveh, or like Sodom and Gomorrah. We need to repent. And so God is sending us Christians to our cities, like Jonah was sent, to proclaim the word of God, to preach an uncompromising message, to speak against evil and wickedness. Today there is a lot of fear, there is a lot of compromise. We should not be like Jonah, who feared and compromised. We should stand and face these cities and city dwellers and tell them to repent. If they don't repent, the Lord is going to destroy them. We need to be true to God's message. Be true to God's calling. We are a prophetic voice in every city. Every church must be preaching a prophetic message against what is going on all over the cities. And when we preach and we are faithful and speak to the cities, they are going to receive the Lord like Nineveh received the Lord. Nineveh received God. Nineveh repented and their kings and their leaders, and God forgave the city. The salvation and destruction of our cities depends on you and depends on me. So let us obey the call to go. Let's not be like Jonah. May God bless you as you target your city where you are to proclaim an uncompromising message of Jesus Christ. And God is going to go with you. In Jesus' name, amen.